to you. 2K Sports presents the NBA. And our broadcast team tonight, Greg Anthony here to my left and Steve Smith to my right. And the Hall of Famer, David Aldridge, along the sideline. D.A., take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, we all know Ja Morant's a high flyer. He says, my dad was pretty athletic when he played, so I can say some of it comes from him. Jumping on tires and the other drills, they just allowed my legs to get stronger. It's enabled me to get off the floor quicker, be more explosive, and it shows when I'm out there on the court. Kevin, it certainly does.
He is a high flyer indeed. David, thank you. Here are the starters for Milwaukee. We've got Holiday. Antetokounmpo is out there with Bobby Portis. Then it's Porter. And it's Lopez in at the five, patrolling the paint. And for Memphis, at the forward spots, it's Brooks and Jackson Jr. And at the guard spots, Morant and Bane. And it's Adams in at the center.
We saw glimpses of Ja Morant's potential in his first two seasons in the league. But year three, both Ja and Memphis took it to another level.
Tip-off goes to Milwaukee. Giannis outside. Back to Holiday. Outside, Porter lets the three fly. A second chance effort, and two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
And I know this coaching staff loves seeing Lopez play a physical brand of basketball, even if it means he has to take a few knocks here and there.
And the first one drops. Another level indeed for Ja Morant, his third season, Smitty, in the NBA. And now he has joined the conversation for MVP.
Kevin, that scoring average well over 25 points per game. Morant is the leader of Memphis. The Grizz finishing in the top three of the West. Incredible for a 22-year-old.
Second free throw, no good.
Yeah, most bigs don't shoot free throws as efficiently as Lopez. The coaching staff has to appreciate that part of his game.
And it's Porter with the ball for the Bucks. It's stolen by Adams. It's Brooks on the wing. Antetokounmpo defending. Brooks misses. On offense, here are the Bucks. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis this season.
And you have to love it when there's a matchup like this. Two teams that are at the top of their respective conferences going at it.
This is going to be a fun first game between these two squads. Buckle up.
Brooks misses. Here's Giannis. Count that one. Giannis has got his second basket.
How about the effort? You didn't think a little contact would prevent Giannis from scoring, did you?
Brooks with the bounce pass. Porter against Bane. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now one for two.
They finally hit one after missing three straight.
Antetokounmpo passes to Holiday. Back to Antetokounmpo. Pass to Holiday. Outside Portis. The Bucks working the ball around. Just five to shoot. Here's Holiday. And the rejection by Jackson. Morant against Holiday. Out to Brooks. There's the triple. Drains it from beyond the arc. And that makes it a tie ball game.
You can run these plays for Brooks. He's improving in the catch and shoot area.
Porter finds Giannis. Releases. The shot misses. Now Memphis takes it the other way. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
And a lot of that was game plan. Putting guys in a position to succeed, particularly on the offensive end.
They understood what the defense was trying to take away and game planned a great strategy to take advantage of.
Whistle blows, basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play. That sends Dylan Brooks to the free throw line. It goes on Giannis Antetokounmpo. The Grizzlies shooting their first foul shot of the night.
And they've done some really nice work at the foul line, knocking down 80%.
And even here, in the middle of the season, Steve, some players are really putting in the work and playing with postseason energy.
Well, that's a mark of greatness in my book, Kevin. Guys who value every game and don't want any unnecessary losses on their record.
Now, here's Lopez. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. And again, the Bucks miss.
You expect him to make that, especially from that distance.
Here's Morant. Good D by Lopez.
He is so good attacking the rim. It's rare to see him denied like that.
Outside Holiday. To stop the run. And it's Lopez laying it in.
When you've gained a decade or more of experience, this is what tends to happen. Holiday stand very patient, waiting for someone to break free.
Now, here's Bane. His last outing with 20 points. The pass to Jackson. Good, and the nice assist from Morant.
So active inside, and with that big frame, Jackson has no trouble finishing through contact.
Porter kicks to Holiday. Lopez outside. The kick out to Porter. On the wing, Holiday trills the three-pointer. It's a tie ball game.
Certainly capable from distance. Defenses no longer dare Holiday to shoot from out there.
Porter against Bane. Here's Morant. Now on the scoring column with that bucket. 1 for 2 this game.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
Back to Porter. Lopez left side. Antetokounmpo looking it over. Launches a three. That's good from Porter on the assist by Giannis.
Shooting while in rhythm. Porter Jr. has an impressive understanding for when to let that thing fly.
Right side, Jackson. Outside, Bane. Back to Jackson. Deep two from Brooks. And good. At the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. That's now 8 points for Dylan Brooks.
Man, he has come out focused and efficient. Love what he's doing at the offensive end.
Lopez goes to the reverse layup and drops it in.
Good job of stepping up to the plate there, seizing back the momentum for his team.
That's the competitor in him. Close game. Let me have this one.
Now here's Morant. He had a 21-point outing in their last game against Atlanta.
And that is the exact type of opportunity this offense is looking to create.
You know, if you get the ball to the right guy in the right spot, more often than not, you're coming away with points.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
At the line for the Bucks, Drew Holiday. Two shots.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
An all-star, a leader, Drew Holiday can be counted on night in and night out to make a difference.
And some changes here for the Grizzlies. Tillman, he's checked in for Adams. And Tyus Jones subbed in for John Morant. The Bucks also with the sub. Daniel Gafford's checked in for Bobby Portis. And so he makes both from the line. The Grizzlies trail by 3. Outside, Jones, 11 feet away, and the rejection by Gafford. Well, Greg, I'm sure their coach is very pleased with their offensive flow right now.
I mean, it's harder than it looks to get it going like this. Now they just have to maintain it.
Now, here's Porter, coming in off a 21-point game his last outing. 4 on the shot clock. Here's Holiday. It's rebounded by Memphis. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Payne for three. Rebounded by Gafford. Milwaukee leading by three. Pass to Antetokounmpo. That one good for two.
Timeout, timeout.
And it's 6 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo. So timeout called here. The first for Memphis.
And coach can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused. It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive.
For Memphis. Brandon Clark, he's checked in for Jackson. Williams comes in for Brooks. And Conchar subbed in for Bane. George Hill's checked in for the Bucks. Carter comes in for Drew Holiday. Here's Tillman. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Here's Conchar. He's guarded by Hill. Jones, no luck.
Okay, that's frustrating. You work hard to get these open looks. You know he liked that one back.
That one goes in. Now it's a 7-point Bucks lead.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Passes to Conchar. Back to Jones. Clark against Gafford. Right side. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
And I love that range there from Clark. At this point in his development, it's not as daunting as trying to be a consistent three-ball shooter.
Antetokounmpo, no good.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
And Clark is right there.
And all of his athleticism on display there. Clark's work ethic makes him lethal on that offensive backboard.
Carter finds Hill. Williams against Antetokounmpo. It's back to Hill. Tries a three. He can't get it to go. And it's Memphis the other way. Pass to Conchar. To the paint. Here's Clark. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
And with a quick break in the action, here's some numbers for Jones. First and three-point shooting. And then there's his work at the free throw line where he holds the best percentage league-wide.
And not only is he hitting from deep, he's doing it with great consistency. One of our league's most efficient three-point shooters. First one falls for him. The Bucks making a switch here. The Ibaka's checked in. Good on both. And so it's Carter who brings the ball up for Milwaukee. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
And that was a game to forget. You'd like to find some teachable moments, but I think they'd like to just turn the page and move forward.
Nothing wrong with that. Sometimes we overanalyze things. Can be better to just let it go.
And they pick up two. And the Bucks lead by three.
It's easy to tell that he is most comfortable pulling up from that area on the floor.
Outside Williams. And the pass to Tillman. Shot clock at 6. Pass to Jones. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
First personal foul. Third team foul.
For Memphis, they have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3.
At the line for 2.
First free throw is good. He hits both from the stripe.
We've seen him put a lot of pressure on the defense and then cash in at the line.
Giannis dishes to Ibaka.
2 minutes remaining.
Carter kicks to Hill.
2 minutes.
Passes it to Antetokounmpo. He doesn't hit that one. Now the Grizzlies take it the other way. Here's Conchar. He's guarded by Hill. Conchar, the pass to Tillman. Sinks that one from the post. Guys back and forth this first half.
And this could continue to go back and forth the entire way.
Ibaka outside. It's back to Hill. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And Hill, very steady at the free throw line. Not the guy you want to give any cheap fouls against.
The Bucks shooting their 5th and 6 free throws of the game.
And they've been ordinary on the season as well. Just about 75% from the line.
2 shots.
And he makes the first.
George Hill, you know he's one of the more versatile guards we have in the game. He can defend ones or twos, one of those players who could fit in on any team in the league.
Both free throws good from Hill. And so here's Memphis. They trail by 1 to the left side wing. Here's Conchar. He's guarded by Hill. Here's Clark, and it's blocked by Ibaka.
And that's how you do it. Ibaka still able to surprise people very quick off the floor.
And the shot is good. And the Bucks lead by 3. And a closer look here at the hustle stats for the Bucks.
Well, it's tough to score when you're getting stuffed on every attempt. Great job getting the hands up so far, making life difficult on shooters.
And they are also just outworking the opposition in transition. When the break is on, they've continued to find ways to score.
And the basket by Jones.
Wow, fired that bounce pass in there beautifully.
Milwaukee's gone 2 of 5 from three-point land here in the first quarter. Hill passes to Gafford. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. And that one drops for him. Antetokounmpo's got 10 points in the game.
Throughout the evening, he's gotten to his spots, and the defense has not adjusted.
Count it.
I'll tell you what, I'm not sure these guys can keep this up.
Yeah, both teams in the zone early. Stops have been almost impossible to come by.
So strong. Giannis has really added some bulk since entering the league. Helps him absorb the contact.
Giannis Antetokounmpo, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for the Milwaukee Bucks. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And getting going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Bucks, guys.
Yeah, in that first period, they look to push in transition at every opportunity.
That's their mindset. Attack, attack, and attack some more. You're not going to beat them playing soft.
The Grizzlies trail by three. The wingmen are Bane and Brooks. Adams is the pivot for him with Jackson Jr. at the four. And it's Morant in at the one. That's the group for Memphis to kick off the second quarter. Now here's Brooks. He picked up 27 points in their last win against Atlanta.
And it wasn't just the points. He brought hustle. He brought energy. And he brought it on the glass. Give him a lot of credit. He's always looking to be aggressive on the offensive end.
Well, Smitty, after his sensational rookie season, I think people knew that John Moran had an unlimited ceiling.
Kevin, now we know it's not just high. It's through the roof. Ja was Rookie of the Year, and he keeps up in his game. We could, Kevin, be looking at an all-time great.
And here comes Holiday leading the fast break. The shot by Adetokounmpo, nobody around, and it's off from three-point range. Pass to Morant. Just over 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter. Brooks kicks to Morant. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. And Holiday has it in the corner. The shot off that time. Morant with some nice D. There's the lob to Jackson, and Jackson throws it down hard.
Putting that 7'4 wingspan to good use. Jaren Jackson with the easy catch and flush.
Now the pass to Giannis. Quarter outside, up and in, off to an efficient start, 2 for 3 from the field.
This is the shot you want to get him, an open look from range.
Good on that shot. With that, the Bucks lead is cut to just one on the basket from Jackson.
Good concentration by Jaren. A little contact on the shot, no problem.
Back to Porter. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. Holiday's got his third assist on the night.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Now here's Morant. 5 points in the game. Shot clock at 5. Back to Bane. Shoots the 3. Rebounded by Gafford. Gafford's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Pass to Antetokounmpo. Porter looking it over. Great D that time from Bane. The Grizzlies trail by 3. Here's Jackson. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a 3-point play chance here for him.
One of the few concerns scouts had with Jaren Jackson, could he rebound at a high level? He did it right there.
And part of the Grizzlies' breakout 21-22 campaign, the emergence of Jaren Jackson Jr.
Triple J, GA, missed most of the 2021 season with a knee injury he sustained in the bubble. When he was back at 100% for the Grizz, he provided serious rim protection, plus the ability to hit a 3.
The free throw drops for Jackson. And you hear the term point forward. But then, Greg, you had Magic Johnson, 6'9", but still a point guard. So what's the difference?
Well, when you talk about a point forward, it's someone whose versatility extends to their playmaking. And Magic is the rare talent who redefined the point guard position.
Now, here's Porter. 8 points for him. And with Kevin Porter Jr. and Michael Porter Jr. and Otto Porter Jr. Guys, I'm sensing a pattern here.
It can even get a little confusing at times, but no relation that I'm aware of. They're just Porters, Juniors, and quality NBA players.
Free throw good, Porter.
And one of those guys who fell in the draft the year he came out due to injury. Porter healed up and has taken the league by storm.
So one for two that time at the stripe. Memphis trailing here. To the middle. Here's Jackson. Cross contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
In a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Grizzlies.
For me, they made a point to attack inside early in the game, and it's paid off for them. A lot of solid looks in the paint.
And another thing coach will be thrilled with, the assist numbers, spreading the wealth and creating some offensive opportunities.
Jaren Jackson, I think about his mobility on the defensive end. He can dart out to the perimeter shooters and recover to the paint better than most guys his size.
Second personal foul. Now it's the numbers for Desmond Bane.
And guys, point of emphasis for the league is to really crack down on illegal screens.
Yes, the last few years, the rules changes have tended to benefit the offenses. This evens things out a bit.
Now here's Morant. He's got five, and he makes that one. Morant's got the lead up to four now for the Grizzlies.
There's a fearless side to Ja Morant, even amongst the trees.
Back to Porter. Giannis outside. Outside Holiday. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. Here's Marjanovic. The kick out to Holiday. Shoots over Morant. And off the left side of the rim. And it swirls in for him.
As usual, Holiday just going about his business. Isn't worried about who's trying to check him.
Pass to Bane. And it's Brooks in the corner. Off target with his three. Milwaukee's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. No good on the triple. And so it's Payne who brings up the ball for the Grizzlies. That'll be game one of a four-game road trip.
And for Jackson, it's about staying after it. This is what allows him to catch fire.
Holiday, the pass to Porter. Now, Antetokounmpo. And here is Portis, guarded by Jackson. Here's Antetokounmpo over Brooks. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It goes on Dylan Brooks. For Milwaukee, they have scored 6 points from their eight attempts at the line so far.
Antetokounmpo, two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. Lopez is checked in for the Bucks. That one misses.
And something that gets overlooked is how good of a passer Steven Adams is.
You're totally right, GA. He's gotten much better with his vision. Knows how to find cutters and open guys out of the high post. Plus, he's skilled at throwing those full court touchdown passes.
Milwaukee with the ball. Grizzlies making the shot. Holiday finds Lopez. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time. Holiday's got four assists in the game. Brooks outside. Back to Morant. Dishes it to Jackson. Brooks outside. They grab their own miss. Outside, Bane. Just four to shoot. And it's good, 2 points. Baines got his second basket of the game.
The team trusts Baines to hunt shots and not to waste touches.
Here's Holiday, and there are the Bucks with another bucket.
Terrific play. This is why you run your offense through him and live with the results.
Brooks outside. Pass to Jackson. Brooks kicks to Bain. Morant outside. Misses the three.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
And there's the pass to Holiday. Down it goes. That's 4 time made out, from the field. He's 4 of 8.
You know, he's had better starts, obviously, but he's shaking it off here in the second.
Timeout called. The Grizzlies.
Well, it's a player's league, but certainly coaching has its place.
Yeah, if that weren't the case, you wouldn't see so many coaching changes in the offseason.
On your feet, fans, here they come, your Grizzlies.
Going with almost an entire new group here. Tillman, he's checked in for Steven Adams. Brandon Clark comes in for Jackson. Conchar's checked in for Dylan Brooks. And Tyus Jones subbed in for Morant. Milwaukee also making some changes. Serge Ibaka has checked in for Portis. And it's Carter in for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Here's Conchar. No points in the game yet for him. From the arc, Serge Ibaka with the rebound. And so it's Carter who brings the ball up for the Bucks. Holiday gets the bucket.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Pass to Conchar. Going inside. Now on the scoring column with that bucket. 1 for 2 this game. You talk about a back-and-forth game. This is the definition.
You have to love these kinds of games, scoring-wise, keeping everybody on their toes.
Feeds to Lopez. The jump hook. The shot that time, not on target. Now the Grizzlies take it the other way. Puts it up from 12. Rebound, Milwaukee. Lopez has got his 5th rebound in this one. And the foul called on Xavier Tillman. That's his first foul. The Grizzlies making a switch here. Williams is checked in. The Bucks also with the sub. Hill's checked in. Let's take a second look at that fantastic block.
And in a close game, blocks like that are so clutch. And that could be a real difference maker here tonight.
Outside Holiday. Lock at 6. Another shot. It's rebounded by Memphis. Clark kicks to Williams. Buries the long-range jumper. Williams has got his first 3 points of the game.
With this lead, they're playing confidently, showing a quick trigger from beyond.
Carter, the pass to Lopez. Hill against Williams. Williams with the block. Jones against Carter. Tillman passes to Clark, and the shot goes in. Now it's a 6-point Grizzly lead.
You gotta know, this is Clark's skill set at this stage of his career. He takes quality shots when he's inside.
Now here is Hill. 14 points from him the last game against Golden State. Here's Williams. And that comes off the assist by Jones. Williams has got the lead up to 8 now for the Grizzlies. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Carter for 3. And there's the foul. He goes on Serge Ibaka. That is his first foul of the game. Baines checked in for Williams. Milwaukee also making some changes. Daniel Gafford's checked in for Lopez. And Antetokounmpo subbed in for Jrue Holiday. A 1:50 left to play in the first half. Jones against Carter. And here's Jones. He picked up 24 points in their last win against Atlanta.
His shot's just, it's not there right now. With his team leading, perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game.
Back to Antetokounmpo. Carter outside. They get it back. That one's good, and the Grizzly lead has cut down now to just 6 on the basket from Antetokounmpo.
And with his length and explosiveness, it's never a surprise to see Giannis get points on the offensive glass. Great nose for the ball.
Now, here's Bane. 6 on the shot clock. Jones from outside. Rebounded by the Bucks. Gafford's got rebound number 5 here tonight. And they call an illegal screen here.
That's great. And not the most common call you'll see in the NBA, but hard to argue that pick wasn't illegal.
It's often a tough call that can go either way, but I agree with you on that one.
Now here's Jones. He's got 6. Now Carter. Giannis outside. Ibaka down low, working on Jones. That one's good, and the Grizzly lead is cut down now to just 4 in the basket from Ibaka. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Outside, Bane. Two points, that one goes. Bane's got 4 points in the quarter.
Weaving his way through the paint, Desmond Bane flexing his way to the basket.
Antetokounmpo. And it's buzzer beater.
And give him credit. Good awareness of the time remaining.
That is situational basketball. It takes a good understanding and good execution.
It's been all about Jaren Jackson for the Grizzlies. He totaled 14 points in the quarter. He's given them all the offense they need right now. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with Coach Mike Budenholzer. Coach, probably not the defensive effort you were hoping for thus far.
Yeah, no, our defense isn't where it needs to be. I think they're getting open looks. We're overshifting, and then we're not committing to shooters. Just not a very good defensive effort so far.
Mike, thanks very much for your time. Kevin, back to you.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway. Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game it's been so far. You look at Antetokounmpo in this one. He's been everywhere.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him. Really staying focused on quality shots.
And many of those quality shots have been jumpers. A very high percentage of those in the first half.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got. They've got Portis. Holiday out there with Kevin Porter. Then it's Brook Lopez. And it's Giannis in at the small forward position. Now here's Adams. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Morant left side. Payne for 3. Good, and a nice assist from Morant. Morant's got his 5th assist in this one.
Quick decision making of Desmond Bane, not wasting any time going up with his shot.
And 2 shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
First personal foul. First
he's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
At the line for the Bucks, Drew Holiday. At the line for two.
That free throw good from Drew Holiday. Both free throws good from Holiday. So it's the Grizzlies now. It's a 5-point game. Morant passes to Bain. Brooks feeling it out a bit. Bain with the bucket. 11 points for Desmond Bain.
A player who's aware of everything around him. Brooks sees the man break open and hits him.
Dylan Brooks seems like a very spirited player, Smitty. He plays with a lot of emotion.
I've heard coaches say he's the team's biggest cheerleader, whether that's game time or practice. Kevin, he loves to motivate his squad to be at their best.
Here's Bain following the three by Milwaukee. Jackson finds Brooks. And there's a whistle that goes on Dylan Brooks. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Oh, great defense there. Anticipated the play and got there first.
Always good to get another look at a terrific defensive play.
And guys, that is lockdown defense at its finest, going right at the shot and then able to knock it away.
And we're about a minute and a half here into the second half. Lopez passes to Porter. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Holiday trying to free himself up. Great D that time from Bain. Into the third we go. 2 minutes in now. And it's Brook Lopez with the foul.
First personal foul.
That's his first foul.
First team foul.
Against Jackson. The three from Morant. Rebound Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Goes back up. Count the basket and the foul. Steven Adams picks one up.
Must put a body on Porter's. He loves to crash the offensive glass.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
Yeah, he's at 81% from the line, and when we've had a chance to see him, he's had great form and continues to look confident.
One shot, one shot.
Free throw good, Portis.
Speaking of Bobby Portis, he's going to fight, he's going to scrap, he's going to give you maximum effort every night.
Passes it to Adams. Brooks against Antetokounmpo. Morant with a wide open look. And again, Memphis no good. The Bucks have gone 2-4 here to start the second half. On the wing, Porter. Guarded by Morant for the lead. And that one's good by Porter. Porter's got 5 points now this quarter.
And that's got to frustrate the defense. Porter Jr. finding a way to score despite the aggressive coverage.
Morant passes to Jackson. Six to shoot. With the fadeaway. Count that one. Jackson's got 18 points in the game.
Boy, this is what we talk about with Jaren. The ability to score on all three levels.
Holiday, the pass to Portis. Antetokounmpo with the ball. Floats one. That shot, no good. And Memphis the other way now. Morant, right side. Outside, Bane kicks it to Brooks. Oh, good with the triple. And it's Porter with the ball for the Milwaukee Bucks. Looking ahead, they've got the Jazz coming into town for the next game. That game is the first and last of their homestand.
And we talk about Antetokounmpo's all-around skills, and tonight it's been about the scoring. He's put this offense on his back.
From deep, Brooks, and the three ball is good. He's got 11.
Really in a good position thanks to the accuracy from beyond.
Timeout. Milwaukee calls their first timeout of the game. You look at Jaren Jackson, what a contribution.
And he continues to burn them with his scoring. The coaching staff's going to have to come up with a different approach defensively.
It's checked in for Lopez.
Already taking the court. Give it up for Greenberg. Let's give a big round of applause.
On defense, Memphis. The lead is two. Giannis outside. And out of bounds as Memphis gains possession. The Grizzlies have gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. Outside, Bane. Pass to Jackson. It's rebounded by Portis. Portis has got 6 rebounds in the game. There's Porter with the 3. It's hauled in by Adams. Adams has got rebound number 5 here tonight. Morant looking around. Takes it from 10. The shot, no good.
That's his shot. Close to the basket. Had the defense on his heels. Kicking himself right now.
And that one's good by Giannis.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from the paint.
Morant dishes to Brooks. Back to Morant. Just 5 on the clock. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. And the rejection by Giannis.
That's just being out of sync and at the worst time, costly.
Tyus Jones, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. The Bucks also with the sub. Carter, he's checked in for Jrue Holiday. Here's Giannis. And he uses the glass on the layup. Antetokounmpo's got 6 in the quarter.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Out of hand on it.
Great size by Bobby Portis. Would love to see him block more shots, but he got all of that one.
And that one's good, Antetokounmpo. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stance for Milwaukee?
It's easy for me. Look at their defensive effort all game. The block total shows their commitment to contesting shots.
And I'll tell you, the energy they've shown in the open floor, boy, it has been terrific, doing a phenomenal job converting in those situations.
Adams. And that comes off the assist by Jones. Adams has got his first points of the game.
Imposing his wheel. Steven Adams gutting it out against good defense.
Carter, the pass to Portis. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. That's on Jaren Jackson. And this will be his 2nd and 3rd shots at the line here.
Bobby Portis taking two shots.
Free throw good, Portis.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
And the Grizzlies with some changes. Tillman, he's checked in for Adams. Brandon Clark comes in for Jaren Jackson. And Conchar subbed in for Brooks. The Bucks also changing it up. Daniel Gafford comes in for Marjanovic. And it's Hill in for Porter. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. The Grizzlies trail by five. Timeout called. The Grizzlies.
It's that time, man. Who wants a free t-shirt? Get back.
Carter against Jones. Shoots from the elbow. Rebounded by the Bucks.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
And Hill has it in the corner. And Giannis gets it to go on the assist by Hill. Antetokounmpo's got the lead up to seven now for Milwaukee. The pass to Conchar. Now here's Jones. Pass to Conchar. Lock at six. From past the arc. Milwaukee with the rebound. Portis has got seven rebounds in the game. Takes it from 10. Hill, no good. Memphis is going a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half. And it's Clark slamming it down.
With the ball in his hands, Ja draws so much defensive attention. Got his teammate a clean look.
Carter finds Portis. The Bucks working the ball around. And again, Milwaukee with the triple.
That pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
Now here's Morant. 7 points in the game. Hill looking around. Carter against Clark. Here's Gafford. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
And loving the strategy. Even though you're well ahead, you want to stay in attack mode.
You want to stay aggressive right at the rim, driving another nail into the coffin.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. The Grizzlies making a switch here. Baines checked in. Serge Ibaka has checked in for the Bucks. Porter comes in for Carter. And the free throw, no good. And so it's Payne who brings up the ball for the Grizzlies. Trailing by 10.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
Now, here's Portis. 10-point lead. This is their biggest. Morant against Ibaka. A floater, Tillman. Great positioning on the putback.
Just in a perfect position to grab that rebound and then get the putback.
Outside Hill. Back to Porter. Portis kicks to Porter. That shot misses. Morant with some nice D. To the inside. Tillman. Up and in on the way. Tillman's got 4 points now in the quarter.
He is really shouldering the load on the offensive end and doing an outstanding job. But he needs the rest of his team to step up.
Timeout called. The Bucks. Changes here for the Bucks. Antetokounmpo comes in for Portis, and it's Holiday in for George Hill. Here's Holiday, 15 points in the game. It's Antetokounmpo on the wing. Back to Holiday. Bane against Giannis. Six on the shot clock. The kick out to Portis. Good, and it's Giannis picking up the assist. Giannis has got assist number 5 here tonight. Passes it to Jones. Bane with it. Pass to Morant. Fires from deep. Connects from 3-point range. Morant's got 10.
It's enough to where you have to respect him. Had one triple in the first half, now has his second.
Porter finds Giannis. Outside, Porter. And the rejection by Clark.
Well, this is where measurements don't tell the whole story. Clark is a tremendous shot blocker despite having an average wingspan.
Now here's Giannis. After the miss from Desmond Bane. Tries from 7. And Drew Holiday. The bucket on the assist from Adetokounmpo. Antetokounmpo's got 6 assists here tonight. Here's Jones. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup. Jones has got his 3rd bucket of the night.
A little artistry in the painted area, converting against the size.
Proving once again that when you attack with confidence, good things tend to happen.
Now, here's Gafford. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game.
And after really leaning on that 3-point shot in the first half, seeming like they're just getting away from it here in the second. More of the shots coming from the interior.
The pass to Clark. Outside, Jones. Good work defensively by Ibaka. And so it's Milwaukee holding on to an 8-point lead heading into the break. Shooting the ball so well in this one. A great performance from the field. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
Fundamental basketball. Keep your eyes up. Keep the ball moving. You're going to keep the defense on his heels.
Fourth quarter of action is upon us. Thanks, as always, for joining us. Bucks leading by 8. The wingmen are Bane and Brooks. Then it's Tyus Jones. Then it's Brandon Clark. And it's Tillman in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the lineup out there for the Grizzlies. Lopez dishes to Giannis. Outside Holiday. Basket made. That gives him 7 field goals and 13 tries.
Good decision maker out of the pick and roll. Holiday calls his own number, rewards his team.
Pass to Bane. And Jones has it in the corner. Holiday, the pass to Porter. There's the dish to Ibaka. And the layup's good off the glass. Ibaka's got the lead up to 13 now for Milwaukee.
Powerful move. Ibaka with the natural explosiveness to finish through contact.
Back to Brooks. He dishes it to Jones. Bane looking around. He gets it in there.
I love the confidence of Desmond Bane in which he plays with. Not afraid of contact, plays right through it.
Some changes for Memphis. Adams comes in for Tillman. And it's Jaren Jackson in for Brandon Clark. Portis, who's checked in for the Bucks.
One shot.
One shot.
And Bane, no good on that one.
We know he can pass it. He's a tough defender, and Desmond Bane can shoot it from all over.
Porter passes to Giannis. Outside Holiday. Good. And it's Giannis picking up the assist. Giannis has got his 7th assist in the game. The Grizzlies trail by 14. Outside Bane. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
There's an aggression and a confidence to Desmond Bane's game. It helps him get to the line.
Desmond Bane, 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
And the first one at the line is good. And good on the second, so he makes them both. And so Antetokounmpo will bring it up for the Bucks. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Porter kicks to Holiday. 5 on the clock. And Adams sends it back.
Look at Adams using all of his impressive reach, firmly swatting that shot away.
Jones dishes to Brooks. Adams in the high post. Jones against Holiday. And it's sent back by Lopez.
And we have seen Lopez really improve his shot blocking. Adept at using that limb to alter shots.
I mean, that's a good job working the ball inside and getting a quality shot.
Timeout called, the Grizzlies. You have to like what we're seeing from Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And he has absolutely worn them out in the paint. They need to come up with a plan to limit his touches
in the interior.
With an update from the sidelines, let's check in with David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Well, Coach Taylor Jenkins talked to his team during the break, and he was emphatic. He said, "We are not going to win this game playing this way, fellas. You've got to step it up. You've got to get aggressive, and you've got to battle to get back in this thing." See if that pep talk got him going, guys.
Thank you, David.
And he's one of those guys you don't have to call plays for. Steven Adams is happy to eat the leftovers.
Jones against Holiday. Antetokounmpo passes to Holiday. And it's Antetokounmpo picking up the assist.
3 points.
Holiday's got 26 points.
And they have been relentless from deep. And you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime, and they're doing a better job of creating space.
Brooks with it. He's picked up by Lopez. Brooks misses. Milwaukee leading by 15. Passes it to Giannis. Nice shot by Portis.
That was physical D, but Bobby Portis is so strong, he finished through contact.
That's tipped. Holiday against Jones. The shot by Holiday, no good.
How is it possible? Wide open too.
Inside. Jones against Giannis.
And how about the attack there from Giannis inside, going right into the defense and still able to get the shot up.
Shooting from the wall, Giannis Antetokounmpo at the line for two.
First free throw is good.
And one difference this half is that when they get to the line, they're converting.
That misses, so he splits the free throws. The Grizzlies trail by 18. Bane inside the three-point line. It's good, the assist this time from Jackson. Now that's 17 points for Desmond Bane. Pass to Holiday. And too much time in the lane, they get called for the three-second violation.
Grizzlies ball.
And Adams has got the ball here for the Memphis Grizzlies. Brooks, left side. And his offensive struggles continue.
Not sure if that's the shot you were looking for, but it's a fairly clean look. Almost have to take it.
I mean, I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Here's the pass to Porter. Holiday looking for an opening. Pulls up. Plenty of room to knock down the shot. Holiday's got 11 here in this quarter alone.
Another nice play by Jrue Holiday. Staying aggressive, scoring the ball at will.
Brooks, the pass to Adams. Bane against Porter. And it's Brook Lopez with the foul.
Brook Lopez.
That's foul number two.
Second
for him.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
Jones for three. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Brooks. Brooks has got three assists tonight.
And he finally gets involved from beyond the arc. His first three of the game comes here in the second quarter.
Now here's Porter. And Holiday kicks to Antetokounmpo. Shot clock at six. Portis finds Holiday. And there are the Bucks with another bucket.
Strong work for him at the offensive end, helping them to maintain that lead.
Jones, the pass to Brooks. Ball's knocked loose. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Jones. Ja Morant, he's checked in for Tyus Jones.
Ja Morant.
Morant against Holiday. Bounce pass, Antetokounmpo. Porter inside. Guarded by Bane. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
His third personal foul.
It's going to be Portis shooting. That's on Jaren Jackson.
Bobby Portis shooting one.
One shot. One shot.
Free throw, no good for Portis. And every year, it seems like outcomes in the playoffs can hinge on health. Steve, it's part of the game, as you well know.
It is, Kevin, and we hate it because obviously health can change the direction of a series or a team. But the one thing teams are doing a better job is they are lengthening and going deeper into their bench.
Now, here's Adams. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two.
You got to bring more than that to stop Steven Adams. Using that strength to bite through contact.
Timeout called the Bucks.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. Call time to just let them get their legs back on.
Present our New Balance player of the game, Jrue Holiday.
And guys, no doubt who our pick was going to be. He's made everyone else on the court look like they're playing at half speed. It's been total domination, and you can't help but just sit back and admire that performance.
Without his heroics here tonight, this could have been a second straight loss for them. But he was sensational, and instead of a losing streak, he may have them headed in the opposite direction now. Portis kicks to Porter. Giannis passes to Holiday. Back to Giannis. Pass to Porter. Clock at six. Over Bane. And blocked by Bane. Outside Jackson. And the refs are going to rule that unnecessary contact. It's a flagrant one foul.
And Kevin, that's a pretty dangerous play right there. I mean, I don't like to see a player put an opponent in harm's way. As much as you just saw him do there, glad they pinned a flagrant on it.
Yeah, you're right, Greg. The officials were all over it. They weren't going to let him off the hook that time. And the first one drops. No good on the second free throw. Adams dishes to Brooks. Here's Bane. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
15-5. At the line for your Grizzlies, Desmond Bane, taking two shots.
Shooting two.
First one falls for him.
See, now he's getting defenders back on their heels a little bit. Getting to the foul line here in the second half.
And Bane drops them both. Bucks leading by 14. Giannis kicks to Porter. Here's Antetokounmpo, right wing. Clock at four. Holiday inside the line. Jump shot is good. Holiday's got 32 points.
This has been a tremendous quarter for him. Everything he puts up now looks like it's going in.
Passes it to Adams. It's Brooks on the wing. Memphis moving it around. Bane passes to Morant. Over Holiday. And that one, good.
Defense is all over Ja Morant, but he keeps his cool and sinks the jumper.
Porter kicks to Antetokounmpo. Pass to Lopez. Shoots over Adams, and Brook Lopez, the bucket on the assist by Antetokounmpo. Giannis has got 10 assists here tonight. So active. Brooks outside. Morant against Holiday. Back to Morant. Out of bounds. Milwaukee takes possession.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
The Bucks making a switch here. Gafford's checked in. Bucks leading by 16. Porter kicks to Holiday. Bane against Porter. Back to Holiday. Over Morant. Grizzlies with the rebound. Jackson's got his seventh rebound here tonight. Morant with it. Out guarded by Giannis. Adams trying to free himself up. Morant with the bucket. Morant's got 4 points this quarter.
Look how Ja just glides through the contact. He's such a nimble player.
The pass to Giannis. Outside Porter. Pass to Holiday. Shoots it up. And the Bucks miss again. The Grizzlies trail by 14. Here's Bane. No good on that one. Holiday with the defensive effort. Milwaukee has gotten off to a great start from three-point range in the final quarter. They're a perfect 3 of 3. Giannis outside. Here's Gafford. Good on the bucket. And the Bucks lead by 16.
And the passing skills of Giannis continue to improve. His floor awareness has grown through the years.
Now, here's Bane. From outside the arc, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Brooks. Bane's got 22.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Here's the thing. He's a guy who will go on hot streaks for you over a number of games.
Holiday against Morant. Portis, the pass to Porter. Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good.
And there's no doubt about this one. Playing with a lot of confidence tonight. It's a statement victory for the Bucks.
Not only did they shoot the ball better, but they had more assists.
Yeah, I thought the passing in terms of finding the open man gave them the higher percentage shots. The ball movement was key for the win.
And a milestone win for the season. This will push their victory total to 20 wins even.
And so they win their first game against this squad. It's a two-game season series, and they'll be going for the sweep the next time they face off.
And we watched them all night long. No one could really stop them. Just another excellent game it was for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Woo, he put on a clinic tonight. Terrific vision, sees the whole floor, and he hits guys in their spots with pinpoint dives.
Porter with it. And so it's the Bucks taking care of business in this one. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Kevin, how about the mental toughness that this group showed? They were never rattled at all by the opposing fans.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Giannis. Huge, big win tonight. How did you do it?
I think we just had fun. I think our guys were running to their spots, and we were able to drive the lanes and make the right pass, and we were knocking down shots, the ball was moving, we were defending, we were having fun, so that's why we got to win.
So you need to patent that formula, I guess. Congrats on the win, man. Thanks. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that about wraps it up. For Steve Smith, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. See you later.